when we reached that pivotal moment of this project. There was a point in time where we really wondered if this could be done. And so it forced us back to the drawing board to figure something else out. So it was about the 2018 timeframe when product management came to engineering and was looking for a product to replace the previous SC1152.
It, for a long time, until Tier 4 Final remained the most powerful stump grinder we offered. That engine wasn't going Tier 4 Final, so we were gonna have to repower it, and everything was much bigger than that engine.
So we really saw the market need for a higher horsepower, larger stump cutter than what was available for our lineup. There's certainly a lot of commercial folks that are doing this job. I'm always looking to be more productive than their competitors, looking to be more productive than maybe a previous machine they had. That market is really what we were trying to fill with the SC1052.
Early on when product management came to engineering with this project, the discussion was certainly had diesel versus gas. But with the torque output, specifically in the RPM range that we operate in, is really impressive. This gas engine that's in the SC1052 and really is pretty well in line with even some of the diesel offerings in similar horsepower ranges.
The requirement where we don't need the after treatment, we don't have to carry DEF on board, we don't have all the filtration up there, that saves a lot of space and allows us to make a more compact machine. We started working with Origin, and the relationship was really a good one. Very open communication between the two. We were both trying to achieve the same goal of high durability, high reliability, high output. The 1052 project specifically, we spent quite a bit of time working with them to make features that allowed our machine to excel in the stump grinder market. So we spent a lot of time with routing and insulation on pipes to try to make sure that we were keeping the heat away from components and getting the heat out of the engine compartment. With that, we kept the operator in mind. We forced all the air out the non-operator side, and that helps increase the comfort for the operator. So during our initial testing, we really came to a pivotal point where we were testing the exhaust flowing downward and up, which is the traditional way we've done it on our brush chippers. And we just could not get insulation to last. The insulation, the thread in the insulation was actually coming apart, and so we couldn't hold things together.
It really forced us to kind of go back to the drawing board, blank sheet of paper. What would we, what could we do differently from this point forward? And that's where we ended up, new exhaust wrap, as well as the custom exhaust routing with the manifolds coming up and out of the engine bay as opposed to down and around.
It's really a hard decision to make too, because in engineering we want to succeed, and we push ourselves until we succeed. And so to really reach that point where the team comes together and we say, this isn't going to work, this isn't a viable solution, and to pivot, that's a big decision that we have to make.
That intentionality comes from our experience, both with our internal customers, so our test team, but also certainly the end users. We do VOC, or voice of customer work, leading up to these projects. And that's an opportunity for us, the engineering team, the product management team, to hear firsthand from the field how these units are being used and things that we can do to solve the problems that they face every day. It's always satisfying for us at the end of a project when we're able to take these units to the field, trade shows, and see customers kind of key in on some of these like specific things that we've done and how that's solving problems for them.
So one feature we have on the SC1052 is a rotatable exhaust outlet. This change came from a conversation with our field application engineer that was down in Florida visiting a customer with an SC852. He got on the job site, they removed the duals and put it into the backyard of a residential home. The stump was positioned such that the only way they could get to the stump was to drive straight in, and that pointed the exhaust directly at the vinyl siding, maybe a foot and a half, 2 foot away. But when he got back and talked to the design team about that, we happened to be working on the exhaust at the same time, and we started sketching things down and talking about it. And we thought it'd be really cool if we could rotate this exhaust outlet so they have some options which way they want to rotate it. So the team got going on that. We had an initial design. It worked okay, but we kept refining it and refining it until we got it the way we want it. And it's been a very big hit with people when they see it. It's one of those small touches that doesn't seem like it's a big deal, But when customers see it, they really like it.
The one thing that really stood out to me about this project was just seeing the first few customers get the machine. You know, there were a few reviews done after the fact, and to see how happy they were with what we had done on this machine and how excited they were for it and how it's going to change their operation and allow them to be more productive in the future with this machine.
The design team was really in touch with the customer and our field test team and paid close attention to the struggles that they had. One of the things that the design team came up with, seemingly a very small, maybe even an unnoticeable feature, is just the little piece of steel that hangs directly below the key switch. You may look at that and wonder why it's there, but it actually serves a very functional purpose.
Our early prototype didn't have that piece. The ignition key is directly above it, and we have a ring on the key, and you put the key locks to the fuel tanks and other things on there. What happens is when you open the door and then you go to close it, the key ring would get stuck in the door. And it was a constant hassle. You had to lift it up and then close the door. So we went to work and fashioned that little triangle piece you see below the ignition switch. And that solves it so the keys don't get stuck in the door.
I think for me, what I appreciate about solutions like this is it conveys the thoughtfulness that the design team has of the end user. And I'm really big on, within the team, the touch points that the customer has with the machines. That's something that the operator, the customer is interacting with every single day, probably multiple times a day. So making sure that those frequent touch points are seamless in operation is really, really key for us.
When the first customer reviews came out about the machine after we launched it, I was really proud to have been part of the team. And so happy to see that we'd hit the mark with this machine and that customers are going to be able to use this day in and day out and really change how productive they can be with their stump cutter business.
When I saw the first SC1052 roll off the line, there was a lot of excitement. The team has spent years developing this. We've had a lot of ups and downs, but we've regrouped. We come together as a team and we fix what needs to be fixed. To see that first machine roll off the line was really exciting and really meant a lot to me and the team.